Well, we made it. We're here. There's a lot of cops. But yeah. Yeah. So, this should be fun. It's colder than balls out. There's Dan.
What's up?
There's Tori. That was a nice.
Love you, little Macy.
Yeah, love you too. Mess my hat up. What the hell?
Oh, did I mess your hair up?
No.
I'm so sorry.
The hat does that by itself. So, here we are in the, I don't even know, somewhere in the building. Got a bunch of vendors and stuff selling, you know, stuff. So, yeah, making our way over to Wheeling first. We gotta get our passes and then we make our way over. Little sneak peek of the inside. Body armor? Ooh. Exhibit Hall B. Alright, so now we just wait here for a guy to come.
Yep.
Come assist. It's gonna be a good day, boys. Here we are. All right, here we got Wheeling. That's really cool.
That's the box that controls the howler, which is the low frequency sub speakers. We call that a fuse block. That's another one. And with the carbide in the cantrol, you can do a secondary siren amplifier or speaker amplifier. That way you can do dual tones.
Okay.
That's what that is over there.
Okay.
That runs off the same weekend wires, like with the light bars or the inner edges run off as well. That's what the expansion module looks like. I can show you that in my truck when it's buried.
Oh, for the...
So if you've got, say Cantrell's got, I believe, 32 outputs, and if you need more, you can add a couple of lights. There's 16 of each of those. The only place I ever seen that many lights is on a demo part.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say that's how Kent's truck is. Kent's truck's got essentially two of those plus the controller itself.
Makes it a Christmas tree.
Oh, yeah. Demo vehicle.
Yep.
You gotta make sure.
You gotta show concept. And this is made by Wheeling, so it's not. This is something they made.
So custom.
strip lights, which is essentially the TI on.
I can't see.
Yeah, that's one thing I've learned, don't look directly at
it. Cass makes a lot of unique housings. What housing are these?
This is the new, it doesn't have a name yet, Super T, I guess. So it's the T Ion, which is this one right here.
Yeah.
It's basically just double the size.
So it's the new tank level lighting. I
really like these silicone optics.
Can you do the pattern for how much water is in the tank? The intent on this is, so this is, the tank's almost empty, but to show the footprint, these diodes are still on, but they're at a low intensity. If you want the entire light to be all red at the full intensity, it also has a low power, you can change the patterns on it, essentially. It's not really a pattern, it's more of how much of it you want to be on, I guess, would be easier. A better way of saying it.
Just this amber, but right now, as it gets forward, it'll change the light color on its own.
Exactly. It hooks up with the electronics that are connected to the tank and the apparatus. So there's a levy through it, it's really based on inside the tank. It tells it sends out an electrical signal to the light
and straight out.
So is that one wire on the back, one, two, four?
More than likely, I haven't seen the back of this thing. It's probably five.
Tori. The side lighting, like the on the sides of the thing? So we're done at Wheeling. Now we're going over to Code 3 area. Yeah? Yeah. So they're just kind of going through places.
I would rather pay $5 for service.
Spartan. Sheffield.
I told you.
This is going to us. Yeah, that's Dayton. Yeah. Sweet. Well, there's code 3. Ooh, buttons. Yay. I love buttons. So, yeah, here's code 3. Got a couple of vehicles. Got a Tahoe. More to come. Ooh, I like that. That gets bright.
Show up and turn those lights on. That's awesome. Let it be there.
You gotta have.
You know what?
Goes the Amber in.
That's pretty cool. Tori's just like, no. That's cool.
25%.
Ooh. That's dope. Okay, so we're done with code 3. Now we're just kind of cruising. We got some drones over here. It's pretty lit.
Yeah. That's like $20,000.
Hey, Joe.
Nah, not exactly.
No, that's $20,000.
That is, yeah?
Yeah. Huh. They're not cheap.
This thing's a freaking beast. Look at that. God dang.
All of eject.
Imagine having something like this on a department. That would be crazy.
It's all on the budget.
Yeah, true.
You just gotta make that budget work.
True. So this ladder truck right here is for Detroit Fire Department. Here we got Federal Signal showing off all their goodies. They've got their controller right here. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Doing good, how are you? Dang, that's dope. That's pretty cool. That wasn't supposed to happen. Uh-oh. I didn't do that.
Just a rumble?
Nah. That's your cue.
Here's the first.
problem, Karen.
Thanks. Okay, Dan.
Well, we're heading over to the stadium now, so we can check out some places there and look at all the Pierce fire trucks and stuff. New Gary fire engine, followed by the new Pierce, what is it called, the Ascendant? The Ascendant, yeah. I can't see it because we're going down here. We'll see. Alright, well, here we are inside the stadium.
We gotta stop this one.
Ooh, it's a nice motorcycle. Honestly, might give me one of them. Right, there's the Ascendant. They have a couple here, apparently.
Arrow XT.
I've seen them on all the
same.
That thing's like brain spanking new.
We used to develop simulators that had screens like this. These are really good.
Right, right, right.
But, you know, the virtual reality headset is far
superior. Ooh. So tempting. It is really warm in here. This thing's freaking nice. That federal signal cue though. Going over to Tomar. Yep, that happened to me too. It happened to me too. Dude, that is dope. I'll just be sitting here. That is dope. I like that a lot. All done, heading on home. Well, we're gonna go get food, and then we're gonna go home, and then I gotta work. So now just to get across the street, talk over a loud Cummins truck. Yeah, thank y'all for watching, and if you guys enjoyed, see you guys.